Please like this video and share it with your friends on various social media. Please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to stay updated on Indian defense programs and technologies.
Dr. Ghosh,
Project Director Ramka.
Sir, KBF seems similar to what you have, at least from a layman's perspective, with the DSI and a giant nose, and it will carry the same engines, maybe. So how much of a design commonality have you given from this program to that program?
You ask the KBF Project Director how much he has taken. See, it's not like that. ADA is an organization, it's an aircraft house. We have various technology directorates and the projects. So whatever capability is being developed, it's, if possible, we always try to put it in whichever program it is happening. What are the good things? So that way, whatever has been developed, it is quite natural that there will be certain commonalities between the various programs.
When can we see the first prototype rollout?
2024, we are targeting the rollout will happen of AMCA.
What systems do you see being mature enough by then?
See,
subsystems.
Already the systems have been matured enough, otherwise we cannot do rollout in 2024. So what we decide for rollout, only mature systems only we can put it.
So for the first prototype, what do you expect to test? And then for the further prototypes?
Generally, it's a standard for certification. The first few prototypes, it is the performance, the system functionalities over the entire domain, and the entire flight envelope to be established. So that would be the initial test to ensure that the aircraft structures, aircraft, all the systems, as well as the performance which is expected, are meeting the targets.
So we've seen many iterations of the design of the AMCA itself. So have you finalized?
This is what the first rollout and the first flight will be look like.
So you're done with all your design iterations? So, including wind tunnel testing and everything, and have you started manufacturing?
The data is being generated, so we are expecting we will start very soon.
So in terms of subsystems, you said only the mature ones would go on.
Yeah.
Right. So will we see an internal LDP or a distributed aperture system sort of a thing on this?
What we have is something similar to DAS, distributed aperture system.
Which will have apertures everywhere.
360 degree coverage.
Okay. Will that remove the necessity for a DC MOS for the aircraft?
See, DC MOS has essentially electro-optical camera and some CCD camera. DAS also considered like that. So it's question of how you functionality of the DC MOS all together combined, enhanced, and other functionalities added. So it is it's one step going over.
Let's not call it weapons bay, internal bay. So have you considered adding current BVR missiles into it? Can it accommodate them?
Yeah.
Can? Okay. So it's still the 2+2 configuration. We can't carry more than that.
It's various combinations are there. Internally, maximum 4 BVR missiles. But you can have a combination of bombs, missiles.
One of the questions that amateur defense watchers have is whether the weight category of the AMCA is sufficient enough, or was it fixed too early enough that given that we are not buying the Russian stealth fighter, would you have preferred something heavier with greater internal volume and internal carriage?
We don't do like that. See, given the Air Force operational, whatever the requirements, we size the aircraft. So while sizing, it has come, this 25 ton.
So you wouldn't have preferred a heavier aircraft with greater internal carriage?
The requirement required that, then it would have automatically come. See, in a design, the first stage, we do a sizing of the aircraft. So accordingly, automatically, it would have come.
But it is a two-way process, isn't it?
It's a design process. Okay.
So they didn't really see the need for something heavier?
I cannot talk on behalf of the users.
The
thing I can tell you, capability-wise, it will be similar.
One of the...
But if you are talking about 40-ton, 45-ton aircrafts, that has a different kind of requirement when it comes.
The reason being, some of the current next-generation aircraft are slightly heavier. Maybe the Korean one isn't. The Japanese one has a 110 kilonewton plus engine development in progress right now. That is the reason for us asking.
See, if you look at the fourth generation aircrafts, the number of medium weight aircrafts are more. Whatever today it's flying are much more than a heavier weight category aircraft, medium weight category. It depends on various, the way you see the future requirement and according.
So the obvious question after that is the question of cost, both in terms of per unit cost as well as serviceability and maintenance cost.
Early stage of the design, once it flies, the aircraft cost is not much. But it all depends the kind of sensors, the weapons. So that adds to the cost. So once the final SOP, which is going to be inducted, is worked out, then roughly we know what would it cost. But since it's made in India, designed by India, compared to other fifth generation cars, it will be drastically less.
Yeah, coming back to the same point, the question of number of hours it needs to get back to another sortie and the amount of money that is needed to maintain such next generation platforms is pretty high.
Have you come across the word IVHM, Integrated Vehicle Health Monitoring?
Yeah.
So this is one of the technologies or capability which has come in fifth generation aircraft. Based on the experience of the earlier aircrafts, what happened? The downtime of the aircraft, preparation time of the aircraft was very high. Now, we have addressed this point from the very beginning. So, we have worked that IVHM started from the inception. Whereas, in other aircrafts, if you see currently, it has come much later stage. So, we have planned it and the design is made accordingly. The next thing, we are not using the kind of, people try to use paints and other things, which after one sortie goes off, again to put in. So this has been worked out, the design, looking into all the aspects.
So we were told that it would incorporate radar absorbing structures also. Can you...
fifth generation aircraft.
So for a layman who doesn't understand what it is, can you...
If you have a flat plate, if you are... electromagnetic waves are going, it will get reflected and come back. So you see the radar cross-section. If it absorbs, then the backscatter is less.
So the biggest question in terms of the program is obviously the engine. So can you share some light on that?
See, initial will be flying with the existing engine, but an advanced 110 kilonewton engine is what GTRE is there, our engine house. There is the process of designing and making it.
Okay. Have they started the program, sir?
They are in that.
And when do you expect an engine to be ready for you? When would you ideally like it?
Generally, the engine takes some time. See, for power plant, I think they are there. It is your challenge how to make people.
Thank you so much for your time, sir.
Please like this video and share it with your friends on various social media. Please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to stay updated on Indian defense programs and technologies.